Hi, I'm Rodney Miller.
And I'm Jann Carl. Thanks for choosing to watch this clip from our Small Town Big Deal YouTube channel.
For full episodes, go to our website, smalltownbigdeal.com.
And subscribe to our YouTube channel to find all kinds of great clips.
Now enjoy the video.
I think it's an instrument that looks simple to play. As long as you've got rhythm, it's not that difficult to get onto it.
Doesn't take talent. You just need some rhythm.
What if you don't have any rhythm?
If you don't have any rhythm, what can I say?
Welcome to the Washboard Festival, a celebration of a humble home device that can keep clothing clean and keep time with the music.
The party is in southeast Ohio, about 50 miles from Columbus on the edge of the Appalachian Mountains in Hocking Hills. The Hocking County seat is Logan, population about 7,000 people. In the heart of Logan is a factory that's been instrumental in keeping the washboard music tradition alive.
The Columbus Washboard Company is the only company in America that still makes washboards. You can't miss it. Just look for the building with the world's biggest washboard hanging on it and come inside.
Is it washboard or washboard?
It's washboard where I come from.
Washboard?
It's
how do you spell washboard?
Washboard.
Washboard.
Don't make fun of the way I talk.
Well, whether you call it a washboard or a washboard, if it's made in the USA, it's made right here. Some of the machinery dates back to the 1930s. The company started up in 1895. It almost went under about 100 years later, but it was saved by investors who wanted to preserve history. For James Martin, that project brought him from London to Logan.
How did it come about that you bought a washboard factory?
Well, just as surprised as you are, to be honest.
James was selling old-fashioned soaps online, and business was bubbling.
I started manufacturing some carbolic soap in small batches. And carbolic soap itself is a laundry soap, so you can use it for everything. You can use it for household, you can use it for yourself, you can use it for whatever. So the natural thing was that people then started asking me for washboards, and here we are now.
I mean, not only did you buy a washboard factory, you moved from England to the United States.
That's
to do
right.
This.
Yeah, absolutely. And I tell you what, when I first came to Logan, Ohio, I absolutely fell in love with the town. Small town Appalachia is something very unique. I just felt like I was at home.
We got a lesson in using washboards from Jackie Barnett, another owner of the Washboard Company. She hails from New Zealand.
You gotta love America. So Jackie's from New Zealand, James is from England, they're in Appalachia, and they saved a washboard factory. Go USA.
Okay, you bring it up, you rub the clothing on the soap. This is your soap tray right here. You may have to balance it with your finger.
Oh.
You get lots of soap on there, and then you just scrub until you make suds. Look at those
suds.
Oh,
that's your suds.
Let me talk about the ridges.
Yeah.
This is your side that you actually would do your scrubbing. Scrubbing your socks, your stains in your jeans and stuff. Now flip it around, and that's a softer, smoother crimp on here, and this is the lingerie side.
So this side, Rodney, is where, when you want to wash all your lingerie.
Yeah, okay.
Gotcha. And I want that to be nice and soft.
Well, I'm glad to learn this, but I don't want to get too good at it.
You can have new chores at home, right?
Yeah. So about how many washboards do you still sell a year?
Well, anything from 20,000 upwards.
And what was the peak when production was at its peak for the company?
It was actually 1941, and we did 1.4 million washboards that year.
During World War II, metal went to the war effort. So the Columbus Washboard Company started making washboards with scrubbing surfaces made of wood and glass instead of metal.
Another historic event, the COVID pandemic, led to a sales spike in 2020.
So during the pandemic,
yes,
people weren't going out to the laundromat.
That's right. We were selling them all to all of the big cities, Chicago, New York, LA, you know, anywhere that people live in, sort of apartments and places like that.
One other place washboards are popular, believe it or not, is in war zones.
We've sent over 6,000 washboard kits over to the troops overseas. It's all done by donations, and we get a wash tub, clothesline, soap, a washboard, and of course directions on how to use it, because these are folks in their 20s and 30s, and they don't necessarily know how a washboard is used.
Over the years, soldiers and Marines have sent thank you notes and photos. In our travels, we've seen a lot of ways that small towns support our troops. But Operation Washboard is one of a kind.
Thanks for watching this clip from Small Town Big Deal. Don't forget to click the subscribe button and be sure to click the bell so you'll be notified when we upload new videos. Also, click the like button. To see full episodes, go to www.smalltownbigdeal.com.